right. Hey guys, it's me, Stormy Grace, and today we've got something a little bit different, but you guys have been hearing about it for a long time, at least since last year when I started collaborating with Astrology Hub. And you can catch me on the podcast there every week with Miss Amanda, who we're here with today. But some of you don't really know what Astrology Hub is, what is it about, how did we end up collaborating? Like, it's neat, I think, to sometimes understand how things came to be. So we're going to do a little chat today, introduce you guys to Amanda, to Astrology Hub, the who, what, where, and why, because we're going into 2020. And there is access at Astrology Hub to so many teachers, so many styles of learning astrology. Just, it's a hub if you want to learn astrology, you know? So Amanda, welcome. Thanks for letting me interview you this time, because I've been on the other side of this a couple times.
Oh my gosh, it's so much fun, Stormy. I always love doing anything with you, and it's just so great to be on your channel with your audience. And I just want to say hello to all of you, especially those of you who have been tuning into the podcast. It's so great to meet you and have another way to connect here. So thank you, Stormy, for having me.
Absolutely. It was so funny. Last year, I feel like the collaboration just kind of came on. And then I was telling everybody about Astrology Hub. And as people were getting signed up for things, they were expecting to see my little face pop up in their mailbox. And they saw you and they were like, who is this lady? And I'm like, it's okay. It's okay. That's the collaboration. You're in the right place. I promise, you know?
That's so funny. Sorry if I've randomly scared any of you, but thank you, Stormy, for spreading the word.
Yeah, absolutely. It was a lot of fun. So tell us, tell all of us, please tell my people about Astrology Hub. I know about it and they know how I came to be, but how did Astrology Hub happen? Let's hear that.
All right. So a little backstory here. So, I mean, if you had told me 7 years ago that I would be doing this today, I would have laughed in your face and thought you were absolutely crazy. I had no idea about astrology. I was totally clueless. I thought astrology was the horoscopes in the back of Vogue, and that was about it. Like, it didn't go any further than that. And I really just didn't ever give it much thought. And what happened was, I was living in New York City, and I have a Capricorn sun, Capricorn Venus, Capricorn Mercury. So I was doing the Capricorn goat thing, you know, climbing the ladder and accomplishing things and getting my degrees and all those things that a good little Capricorn will do. But I hit a point, and it was shortly after I had my first daughter, where I was like, whoa, like, what am I doing? I am on this trajectory. And I'm no happier today than I was before all the degrees or before the successful career, any of it. So, like, where am I going? Like, what is the whole point of all this? And I really just went through like an existential crisis moment where I realized that the life that I had built was not the life that I wanted to live. I realized that my daughter, like, I would barely see her. She'd be raised by nannies because that's kind of what you do in New York City. And I was working 80 hours a week. So that was like the path we were on. So I decided to make a huge life change. And I was married at the time to my college sweetheart, and we had the one daughter, but then I got pregnant with my second daughter, and we decided to move to Hawaii, which is a place that had always really called to my soul. And so we did. So I quit my job, sold everything I owned, and like jumped off the cliff. You know, it was like, and I would have the Joseph Campbell, like, follow your bliss and doors will open where they were otherwise closed, or, leap and the net will appear. Like, I had all those things in my head. So I was like, okay, I'm going to create a new life that's more aligned with my heart and my passion. And I have no idea what that looks like yet, but I'm just going to leave. So we moved to Hawaii, and this is where I always say, like, I would love to be able to say that I like sailed off into the sunset and the rest is history. And look, now I have Astrology Hub and here's this, but it was so not the case. I mean, essentially I moved to Hawaii, and shortly after, like, everything fell apart. My marriage, I was in a total career crisis. I was almost bankrupt. Like, it was like bad, you know, really bad.
Really bad.
Yeah, it was bad. And at that point, astrology came into my life. So I had my first astrology reading with Natasha Alter on the Big Island, which totally, like, synchronistically came together. She's still a dear friend of mine. She's an evolutionary astrologer. And I sat in her living room with tears streaming down my eyes, just going, oh my God, like, how does this person know these things about me? Like, how do they know more about me than anybody that I know? You know, like the deep, dear things. And then it was like, well, and then how come nobody else knows about this? Like, how come nobody else knows about this thing called astrology? Like, she's just looking at a piece of paper with like a, some symbols in a circle, like, and she's able to see into my soul, like, whoa. But as all my my life was really falling apart, astrology became this lifeline. And the more that I learned, the more that I realized how profound it is and how helpful it is and how useful it is. And when I left New York, really my prayer was that I would someday find something that would take my unique gifts and talents and put them into service so that what I did could benefit as many people as possible. So astrology, I was starting to fall in love completely. I wouldn't even say starting to fall in love. Like, I was in love with astrology. And I was at dinner with one of my girlfriends and we would talk about astrology all the time. And her husband like walked in and he was like, you know, I have this domain name, Astrology Hub, that I bought like years ago and I've just been waiting to do something with it. Would you want to help me build something? And I was like, oh, yes. You know, like keyword for Capricorn, build something. Like, yes, let's build something. I have no idea what that means. So anyways, I said yes, again, not knowing what my yes was, but that was about 5 years ago. And it has just been this incredible journey of meeting amazing astrologers like you, Stormy, and with this intention of really featuring and highlighting astrologers in the best light and highlighting astrology in the best light. Because if you, you know, when you Google and you look out there, it's like you're overwhelmed with all this information about astrology. So how do you know like what's real? How do you know what to pay attention to? And how do you know who to go to, you know, when you need the guidance? So for me, it was like, well, let's find the best and the most heart-centered and the most empowering astrologers that we can find. I noticed quickly, I was like, well, there's a lot of like fear-based astrology. I'm like, that doesn't feel good. I'm not about that. Like, I don't want to proliferate that. So we find people like you who are empowering people, who are making people realize that we have choice in this, that everything's not just happening to us. And, you know, through the years, it's just grown. Like it just has a life of its own. And, we continue to just reach more and more people, which I'm so excited about, with people like you. So we have courses and events, like a lot of free offerings. We have the Astrology Hub podcast, which you're on. And then we have our membership, which is a really big part. It's like kind of the heart and soul of Astrology Hub. It's our membership where people get to work with a different astrologer every month and really work with the moon cycle, work with the daily energies, and then have a mastery class teaching in astrology so they can really hone their skills in astrology as they go along. Yeah. And so Stormy, you're going to be one of our inner circle guides for 2020, which I'm so excited about.
I am.
And we have an incredible lineup for 2020. But yeah, so that's the long story behind astrology.
The Cliff's Notes version of your life falling apart and then you find something else, which I have to tell you, I think it's so wonderful. As an astrologer, I like to watch the cycles of timing. And 7 years ago, my life was falling apart, right? And I was like, oh my God, I'm never coming back to this beautiful job that I loved. I loved it and never thought I would leave ever. And I walked in and knew I wasn't gonna come back ever. And my life started falling apart and I slowly started building this business. And 5 years ago, I committed. I was like, this is it. This seems to be what I'm doing. And the best part about it was sitting with my spiritual teacher and she's like, yep, prepare to collaborate, prepare to go meet your fellow astrologers in this industry. And it's like, I love to hear this and share it with people because it's not just us on the internet being magical humans. That's not what's happening. The cycles of life are happening and the people and the places and the events are lining up to meet us if we'll just walk, you know?
Totally. And I love what you say about that commitment moment, you know, and there's many of those, right? There's like those choice points, but those are powerful moments. And I think we all know that intuitively. So we don't do it. You know, for a long time, it's like, well, I know that once I commit to this, it's going to be like game on, you know, and I don't know if I'm ready for game on. But it's amazing how much that catapults the process and gets things moving.
I cannot agree more. And so now we've got another event that's coming on the way, the forecast event, and I'm pumped about it. I'm pumped mostly because I think my eyes are just so open to the depth of the collaboration that is available with Astrology Hub, because I got to spend a year teaching and learning as well. So now as we do this forecast event, what can everybody kind of look forward to?
Okay. So this is my favorite event of the year. You guys, it's so much fun. This is the fifth time we've done it. So we did this like in our first year, and it has been the one thing that just like sticks. Like we do it every single year without fail. And it's essential. It's called the 2020 Astrology Forecast Marathon, because it's literally 3 days of live streaming of me talking to 12 different astrologers. Each astrologer has about 30 minutes. And we talk, we go through every cycle of the year. So we're going through every month and all the key transits and all the key dates and all the key energies and all the things that are coming up so that you can be prepared for the year ahead. It's almost like a Cliff Notes version of the year, you know? Yeah. And every day, so there's the 5 hour, there's the live streaming that happens. Then there's a panel at the end of each day. So every day there's like 4 astrologers featured, right? 4 times 3 is 12. Yes. 4 astrologers featured. And then we have a panel, a Q&A panel at the end. And this is always my favorite part. It's totally unpredictable. It's right. So fun to see the astrologers interact with each other. And it's really fun to see how they can build on each other's ideas. Mm-hmm. So that's an amazing part of the event. That's at the end of each day. This whole event is free, you guys. This is all free. This is like our we love you. Here's our offering. And then on the fourth day is a bonus group meditation live at the exact time of the conjunction of Saturn and Pluto in Capricorn. So that to me is going to be incredibly powerful. And again, unpredictable. A couple of years ago, we did a global group meditation for the Great American Eclipse in 2017. It was like powerful beyond anything I could have ever imagined. Like literally every single person on my team after that event, like had a huge like life experience happen. You know, it was a big catalyst for everybody, both the people that attended and the people that like helped put it all together. So I never know what these things are going to bring, but I just know that we're being called to do it. And I think it's really important that we come together and we like anchor in a sacred space and anchor in love and just send that ripple effect out onto the planet. So that's what it's going to be. So it's basically 4 days this year, because you have the 3 days of the forecast and then you have the bonus group meditation day, and it's happening January 9th through 12th. Yes. And Stormy is going to be featured on that as well. So you must be on day 3. Is that right?
I am on day 3. Yes. I'm in the fall as my lunations go. So yes.
Yeah, so we have astrologers like Kai Pacha and Gemini Brett and Christopher Renstrom, Linda Bird, Shireen Vishmaya, Gary Caton. I mean, the lineup for 2020 is so powerful. And we just knew it was like, okay, we got to bring in the big guns for this big year. And we have an amazing, amazing group of astrologers here to guide us. So I always think of you guys as like translators of the language of light. So, you know, there's all this guidance available to us in the cosmos, and there's certain people who are attuned to be able to translate and hear the messages and then share those with all of us. So it's just going to be a lot of fun to get all your insights.
And it's fun when we do something like that. And like you said, we get to see all of these different translators and astrologers together, listening to each other, listening to questions being asked, and just sharing what's kind of coming through. Because I have seen it where you have a panel of people, they have all said the exact same thing and in different ways. So different students are hearing it. Do you know what I mean? It's the most amazing thing. So it's like literally being able to speak multiple languages and you're all just saying the same thing, but just in a way that your student's heart can hear it. So
well, that's true. And what I'm realizing about 2020, and because you all come from a lot of different perspectives or different ways that you practice astrology, is different people are picking up on different things. Mm-hmm. So there is, of course, everybody's paying attention to the big moments, like in January and in December, and you know, some of the moments in between. But there's also some like elements that are being highlighted that are unique to specific astrologers. So it will be like, yes, a lot of hearing about transits in many different ways. But then also, because we go through each month of the year, there's different transits and different things that will be highlighted during each month as well. So
yes. Yeah,
we have eclipses. We have that, like, even an astrologer reached out to me the other day. She was like, I really want to make sure that people are paying attention to Eris in 2020, you know, the asteroids. So like, you know, people are just bringing in different things that, and all of it is really important for all of us next year.
Yeah, I get to do the Mars retrograde, which I'm pumped about. I think Mars retrograde is a good time to redo some things. And at that point in the fall, everybody's strategy needs a re-look over anyway. So it's going to be good.
Yeah.
Good. And so goodies. What kind of goodies can we take advantage of even before then? I got my 2020 guide.
But so there is also another free resource for you. It is our 2020 astrology guidebook. This is about 12 pages. It's a PDF. And so when I started hearing about 2020, I don't even know how many years ago, all astrologers were already like talking about 2020. When it started to come closer, I was like, okay, I want to make sure this actually is a big deal. And I don't want to hype up something that isn't, if it's not, because, you know, I want like a Y2K sort of repeat. You know, it's like, that would be really embarrassing. So I just started asking all the astrologers that I interview on the podcast, is 2020 like actually a big deal, or is 2020 as big of a deal as some people are saying it is? And across the board, like regardless of astrological orientation or background, every single one was telling me, yes, it's a big deal. Yes, we need to pay attention. Yes, this is one of the biggest deals that we've had in a very long time. So what we did is we compiled all the responses to that question of why. You know, why is it a big deal? So this guidebook will give you all of like a lot of highlights from the different astrologers about why it's a big deal. But then I also asked them, okay, what can we do between now and the end of the year to really prepare to meet that energy? Like, what can we be doing body, mind, spirit to be ready for that? And so we have 9 tips that the astrologers gave us to actually really work with the energy. So all of that is in this little free guidebook that Stormy put the link in the description.
Yeah, absolutely. I'll put the link down there. You guys can grab it. And it's so wonderful because whether you're new or you're experienced in studying the astrology, just kind of hearing the tips and tricks of what's coming is a big deal. And I can tell you that I was coming into astrology and there were significant things happening. And even as an astrologer, I was so overwhelmed by how much astrology was happening. I couldn't really breathe it in. To have something highlighted is really helpful, especially if you're just studying or if you're one of those people out there who's like learning astrology like crazy over this last couple of years. So you've got so much information. This kind of streamlines some things for you for 2020. So feel free to grab it, take advantage. It's helpful. And then come learn your eyeballs off. It's going to be such a big learning year.
Yes.
Learning and teaching. And then we move in May to the Gemini Sagittarian axes. You are going to see students and teachers literally just roll out as springtime comes around. So if you are wanting to learn, if you are wanting to teach, present yourself, because we're here. Everyone's here. We're just waiting for you.
You know what's beautiful about that too? I was just on a podcast interview yesterday with Sasha Benedetti. I don't know if you're familiar with her, but she works with the Venus cycle. And so we're starting a new Venus cycle also in Gemini. And so a lot of that is about stepping into our feminine power as well, our feminine mode of communication or of conveying information and receiving information. So like I said, there's lots of different angles to this year that are really important. And that new Venus cycle is another one. It's like, we're starting a new Venus cycle, which is they last 19 and a half months. And it's the first time that Venus is in Gemini since 2012, when Venus was crossing the face of the sun, like visibly, you know, and people could see it. It's the first time that she's back in that same sign. So there's like really cool, amazing things happening. And the other thing is just thinking about why we all chose to incarnate like at this time, like with all of these big shifts happening, with all of these things happening in our world, like there's a reason we chose here to be, we chose to be here now. So like Stormy said, maybe you're one of those people that's here to teach or to guide or lead or any of those things. And I think we're going to really be asked to continue stepping into those roles.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, I'm excited. I'm glad I got to interview you and that you got to just speak for yourself, because I can tell my tribe all I want about you, but I would rather have you speak for yourself and your brand and your little piece of the world that you're holding down and making available. It's always so much better. So if you're still looking for a tribe, if you want to expand your tribe, you want to teach, you want to learn, whatever your interaction with astrology and your own journey is this year, Astrology Hub is an awesome place to come kind of figure that out. And if you have been studying for a while and felt like you haven't found your teacher, it will be impossible to not find your teacher here at Astrology Hub. I mean, there's just so many of us. So one of us speaks your language, I promise.
You know what's cool too, Stormy, is what I have found about astrology students is it's not a very monogamous thing. They usually have several teachers, you know, and also different teachers at different phases in their learning or in their journey. So yeah, that's it would be impossible to not find at least someone who resonates and speaks your language, and you'll probably find many. So many.
Good. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for spending a little bit of time with us and sharing your gift to the world with us today.
Thank you, Stormy. Thank you so much for having me. It's been great to be here with all of you. Thanks.
All right, guys, look in the description box down below for the link. Get signed up for the forecast event. And of course, you can join us all year long. There is just so much going on. We'll be walking you through every moon. There's ceremony involved. So if you like ceremony, that'll be a good deal as well. And of course, check out the podcast, because we are there every week talking about what's going on day by day in the play-by-play of the week. So check it out in the description box down below. I love you guys, and I'll see you next time.